Welcome everybody to another video Finching Greece Reloaded. Today we will talk about the famous god Kratos. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so as to stay tuned for upcoming videos. Alright, I guess that most people that did not study any ancient Greek mythology or history learned about Kratos from the famous games God of War. Frankly speaking, these games are amazing, and if by any chance you have not played the latest game so far but intend to do so, a piece of advice. When you meet the final Valkyrie Queen, just make sure not to throw your controller at your PlayStation. Been there, done that. Back to our story. As I was saying, Kratos was in a sense a kick-ass god that represented strength and power, but there are conflicted stories about almost everything else about him. What is more, there are two competing versions of his parentage, each of which changes his relation to the other gods. In many myths, Kratos is referred as the son of the Titans Pallas and Styx. This would make Kratos a relative of the Olympian gods, but not one of their direct number. He is often referred to as the brother of several other figures that represent strength and battle. For example, Nike, the goddess of victory, Via, the goddess of force and violence, and Zelos, the god of zeal. In this form, Kratos is seen as a companion of Zeus and the guardian of his throne. He is usually one of Zeus' primary enforcers and is an extension of his will. In a few other myths, Kratos is seen as one of Zeus' many children. Rather than being one of Zeus' peers, he is a demigod, the son of Zeus and an unnamed mortal woman. This form of his history is relatively uncommon, but it does crop up enough to be important. Now, that out of the way, let us take a look at Kratos' appearance in ancient Greek mythology. Surprisingly, and in contrast to what many people may think, Kratos' exposure in the ancient Greek writings is actually limited. In other words, even though whenever ancient Greeks referred to the god of strength and power, Kratos' name would be implied, actual writings about him are limited. What does this mean? It means that regardless of Kratos' origin, Kratos doesn't show up in many of the Greek myths. Because he's not one of the gods with major domain, he's usually seen as a helper of another god and called upon in conjunction with one of his siblings. In fact, Kratos' best known appearance in myth also involves his sister Via, and the story goes as follows. After Prometheus stole fire from the gods, he was sentenced to be bound to a rock and to be tortured for all eternity. Zeus ordered Via and Kratos to go out to capture Prometheus and unchain him on the rocks of the specific mountains. Keep in mind that Prometheus was a titan, meaning that he was not weak at all. Regardless of Prometheus' power, Kratos and Via overpowered him and chained him on the mountains with chains that were forged by the smith god Hephaestus. While this was Kratos' only role in the story, it was perhaps his most important appearance in Greek myth. Moreover, guys, if you ever will get the chance to read the specific story aka Prometheus bound by Aeschylus, the way Kratos talks and acts, you will definitely get vibes from God of War from it. Apart from the story of Prometheus, Kratos does not appear often in the same way that other gods appeared in Greek mythology. Instead, his name is usually called upon by other characters to help them in times of need. Kratos is generally called upon with Via and Nike in battle, but he was also sometimes called upon with Dike, a god of justice. Kratos' role as a god of strength and power wasn't just limited in the battlefield, but he is usually identified with violence. He is one of many Greek gods who seem to exist as more of an idea than as a character in the myths, and it's not that uncommon to see his name without ever seeing his character appear. That being said, let us know in the comment section below if we have forgotten something to talk about in the video so that other viewers can read and learn from your comments. And with that suggestion, we have reached the end of our video. We hope that you did like the video. If so, please do not forget to hit the like button, and if you wish to support the project of Ancient Greece Reloaded, click on the subscribe button to be able to follow our next videos. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for our upcoming videos.